Loving God, in the name of Jesus, Kadevro Zia Dembro de Kataya, Lekla da Gazombra da Caravoshe Catara Voshe de Brodicataya, Robra de Zombra de Catara Voshe Ketere Bojanda Cazobra de Kataya, In the name of Jesus, Father, we worship you, exalt you, we honor you. We lift your name above every name in the name of Jesus. We lift your name above every creature, above every woman and every man in the name of Jesus. Father, we come this Wednesday. We dedicate our lives in your hands. We dedicate the service in your hands. We pray that, Father, may you take preeminence over this service. Take lordship over every woman, every man, every child, boy and girl in the name of Jesus. We have prayed. Praise be to our loving God. I just want to take this opportunity to welcome every woman and every man in this service. I'm just so excited for you. Just go ahead and clap your hands. Go ahead and clap your hands as you welcome that woman inside you in the name of Jesus. Clap your hands as you honor that woman online. Just go ahead and clap your hands. Just go ahead and celebrate the presence of our moms, our dads, our aunts on Facebook, Twitter, on WhatsApp, on YouTube, or around the world. We have people from Africa, Australia, India, Germany. They are all watching us from those nations. Just go ahead and welcome them as we celebrate their presence and as we celebrate their miracles. Praise be to the Most High God. Child of the Most High God, it is your miracle. It is your day for your miracle. I want you to be expectant. I want us to honor the man of God, Apostle Henry E Ssuuna. Just go ahead and clap your hands as we honor the man of God, Apostle Henry E Ssuuna, the gift of God in this nation, the gift of God in this era. Just go ahead and clap your hands as you honor the grace of God upon his life, as you honor the hand of God upon the man of God. Man of God, we highly esteem you. We are blessed because of you in the name of Jesus. And in the same grace, let us celebrate the presence of our heavenly God. Clap, just stand up where you are and you honor the presence of our loving God. Holy Spirit, we exalt you. We highly esteem you. We kalela brazia demro zokotaya. Spirit of the loving God, likla dova zikataya. We acknowledge your presence. We know you are here. Father, may you release your grace. May you release your honor. May you release your glory, your power among us in the name of Jesus. And in the power of the Holy Spirit. Praise be to our loving God. I want us to go straight in the Word of God. Today is Wednesday. It is our day for the Word. Sorry, we started a bit late. Praise be to the loving God. I want us to go in the book of Isaiah, chapter 64, verse 4. Today is our day for the Word. It is our month for the miracle signs and wonders. Praise be to the Most High God. And it is our day for, it is our week for the panel. Men and the women of God are here to release the miracles, to release the miracles, to open for your miracles, to open for your signs. God has sent men and the women of God this week on the panel to make you know, to bring out your insight, to open your eyes, to show you what has been hindering your miracle to come forth. Praise be to our loving God. Isaiah chapter 64 verse 4. I want us to read this scripture. Because this month, we have been waiting for the miracles. We have been waiting for the signs. Why? Because God said, it is your month for him to release a miracle. It is your month for him to release a sign. Praise be to the Most High God. But one thing is expected from you is to be expectant. And as you are expectant, child of God, you are going to receive it. Isaiah 64 verse 4 says, for since the beginning of the world, men have not heard, nor perceived by the ear, neither has the eye seen, O God, beside thee, what he has prepared for him that waits upon him. Praise be to the Most High God. The reason why I'm reading for you this scripture, when I was coming to begin this service, the Lord gave me this verse. That if you have been waiting expectantly this month for your miracle, what God is going to do for you, no eye have seen it. If you are expectant for the miracle this month, what God is going to do for you, no ear has perceived it. Praise be to the Most High God. God is going to use every avenue to make sure that you receive your miracle. God is going to do everything to make sure that you receive what belongs to you. Praise be to the Most High God. Just be expectant, because the scripture told us what God is going to do. No eye have seen it. No ear has perceived. No ear has heard it. No heart has perceived it. What God is going to do for that person who is waiting for him this month for the miracle. I don't know all about you, but I'm waiting expectantly. Why? Because the scripture told me, whoever waits, God is going to do something which no eye have seen. Praise be the Most High God. I want to challenge you, wait for my miracle. Because I'm waiting and I'm believing God on his word. Praise be the Most High God. So as we begin this service, I want to encourage you to be expectant. When God says that what he has prepared for you, no eye have seen, he doesn't include your aunt. He doesn't include your husband. He doesn't include that maybe if your husband allows or your sister allows, this is him and him alone who has prepared it. And what gives me joy, the scripture says, he has already prepared it. It is already prepared, child of the Most High God. God is not going to figure out what to do to give you that miracle. This month of miracles, signs and wonders, the miracle you need is already prepared. And the Bible says that God cannot lie. If he says it is already prepared, it is already prepared. So the men of God and the women of God are here on the panel to let you know how you're going to get your miracle. They are here to let you know what hinders you to receive your miracle. Praise be to the Most High God. I want us to go in the book of Isaiah before we pray. We are going to pray expectantly to pray for our miracle signs and wonders. Isaiah chapter 40, verse 29. Isaiah 40, verse 20. Let's start from verse 28. Hast thou not known? Hast thou not heard? That the everlasting God, the Lord, the creator of the ends of the earth, faints not, neither is weary. There is no searching for his understanding. The scripture says, have you not known it? That the one who has promised a miracle does not faint. Have you not known it? That the one who has promised for you for the miracle does not get weary. Praise be to the loving God. The scripture said, hast thou not known it? It is a question God is asking you. That the one who is going to give you a child, you barren woman, does not faint. The one who is going to give you your healing is able. Praise be to the Most High God. The scripture is asking you that you get to know this. So I'm here to let you know. Get to know that whoever God, the God who is going to give you your miracle, is ready with that miracle. Praise be to the Most High God. He says he does not faint. He's the creator of the ends of the earth. If he can create the ends of the earth, child of the Most High God, he can create that job you need. If he is the creator of the whole universe, he can create the papers you need. He can give you the citizenship you need. He can give you whatever you need, man of God, woman of God. You who is believing God for that project, God can facilitate that project. He owns the earth to the end of it. Praise be to the Most High God. If he could create the whole earth, he can create that miracle you need. He can create that project you need. God can create everything. Praise be to our loving God. But what I wanted is verse 30. Verse 30 says, even the youth shall faint and be weary. The young men shall utterly fall. But they that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. Praise be to the Most High God. I'm here to encourage you. This is our month of waiting upon the Lord for our miracles. But the scripture says, the youth can faint. The young men can fall. But God does not expect those who are waiting upon him to be weary. I'm speaking to you, man of God, who is believing God for a healing from cancer. The young men in the world, if they get cancer, they can get weary. But you who is waiting upon the Lord for your healing, the Bible says, those who wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. So I'm here to encourage you and to renew your strength, that your miracle is on the way. Your miracle is today. Your miracle is now. Praise be to the Most High God. It doesn't matter how big your miracle, the miracle you need. God is able. He can produce that miracle. Praise be to the loving God. The scripture says, but they that wait upon the Lord for this month for their miracles, they renew their strength. They mount up with wings as eagles. They shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and not faint. This is your month, child of the Most High God, that you should mount up like an eagle. Praise be the Most High God. This is your month, child of the Most High God, for you to fly into your miracle. Praise be to our loving God. Is there anybody who is ready to pray for their miracles? As we wait upon the men and the women of God for the panel, I want us to stand up and pray. Praise be to the Most High God. As we are going to pray, I just wanted to let you know this. Recently, I was listening to one man of God, and he gave this illustration that when God is referring, he refers the born again, he refers the church to the ego. Praise be to the Most High God. But the way the ego waits for its miracle is not the same way that human beings wait for their children, for their miracles. Praise be to the Most High God. If a woman is pregnant with a baby, he will see the womb growing to believe that I am pregnant. Praise be to the Most High God. It is very easy for a human being to believe that they're expecting. But the Lord refers to us as eagles. Why? An eagle lays the egg and he waits upon that egg for 35 days, waiting upon the dead egg, but it is believing for the miracle. In all those days, there's no sign that there is a miracle. But the ego has one thing. It has inside the ego, there is a knowledge that the God who created this egg will perform a miracle. Praise be to the Most High God. So child of the Most High God, it doesn't matter whether we began this month, you have not seen any sign of a miracle. Sit upon that miracle. Sit upon that whatever you are believing God. Sit upon that. God wants you to sit upon it in your mind. Let your mind be upon it. Praise be to the Most High God. Let your heart, let your faith remain in one place, that before the end of this month, you will have a miracle. Praise be to our loving God. An ego sits upon that egg. There is no sign of life. Praise be to the Most High God. But the ego doesn't give up to leave the egg. Praise be to the Most High God. It waits upon that egg for all the days until the egg brings out the child. The ego does only one thing, is to sit upon the egg. As the ego is sitting upon the egg and waiting upon that egg, the child will come forth. Praise be to the Most High God. At that time, God has has planned for that eaglet to come out. The eaglet will come out. Child of the Most High God, I'm here to let you know that time God has planned for your miracle to come forth, it will come forth. God wants you to do one thing, is to bruise upon that egg, to bruise upon your miracle. Whatever you are waiting for, sit upon it. Sit upon it with your mind. Let your mind sit upon that miracle. Let your faith keep on that miracle. Do not move from what you have believed God for. Praise be to the Most High God. Because when you move, the Lord was speaking to me concerning that illustration, that when you move away, there are snakes who are waiting to eat that egg. Praise be to the Most High God. There are snakes who are waiting to destroy that egg. But if you sit upon that egg, child of the Most High God, you are going to receive your miracle. That miracle will come forth. It doesn't matter whether there is no sign of life. That ego sits upon that egg when there is no sign of life. For from day one to the last day, child of the Most High God, this might be your last day of your miracle. But you have not seen any sign. The ego doesn't see any sign until the last day it receives that child. Praise be to the Most High God. So that's why God refers to us, the church, his dear children, as the egos. He wants you to wait upon your miracle as the ego waits upon that egg. There is no sign, no sign for the miracle, no sign for any life, but it waits upon that egg. With all the knowledge, with all the expectation that the child will come out. Praise be to the Most High God. So I'm here to let you know, your miracle will come forth. There is no devil who will hinder it. No devil, no witches will stop that miracle. I want us to stand up and pray and talk to this loving God. God gave us this month, that it is our month for signs, miracles, and wonders. Child of the Most High God, the scripture says, you and your children, you are for signs and for wonders. Stand up and pray and declare that word, that God, make me to be, produce out those signs, miracles, and wonders this month. In the name of Jesus, God wants us to confirm his word upon our lives. God wants us to voice that word. This is the night, child of the Most High God, for you to voice what God has said upon your life. He has said that you are for signs and for miracles. In the name of Jesus, open your mouth, child of the Most High God, and talk to this loving God. Lega da vazaya zonda la vazia da gazobra zekataya malagazanda la masara bradeka zobra zekataya. Can I hear a woman who is ready for that miracle declare that I am for miracles, signs, and wonders in this land of the living? I want you to confirm with God. If he say that you are for signs, miracles, and wonders, declare that you are going to be a sign in this nation. No matter your color, no matter your accent, child of the Most High God, you are for signs, miracles, and wonders in the name of Jesus. Just all go ahead and pray. Just guide and declare. Can I see a woman who is ready to believe with God? Can I see a woman who is ready to challenge God for their miracles in the name of Jesus? Father God, we thank you for this service. We thank you for Dominion Assemblies in the name of Jesus. Child of the Most High God, as I told you, that there is no devil who can stop the eaglet to come out. It is only the mother ego. When the mother ego is impatient, when the mother ego moves away, that's the only thing which can hinder the eagle to come out. So tonight I want you to just go ahead and pray. As you are confirming God for those miracles, as you are believing God for the miracle signs and wonders, I don't know what miracle you are expecting God to release, but that miracle is coming forth. This is your night, child of the Most High God. Ragazande leboseka dazara bradeka taya, ramasara brazaya zomfra deka taya. Woman of God who is believing for that anointing, that anointing is coming upon your life. If you are believing God for a new grace,
That new grace is coming upon your life. If you are believing God for a child, that child is coming forth. Just guide and pray, child of the Most High God. Rozo kova zia de kasibro zekataya. Maragazanda la vrazaya zonde zada brodekataya. Open your mouth and declare that me and my children were for signs and for wonders. In the name of Jesus, just guide and pray that Father, make us a sign and a wonder in this nation. Father, in the name of Jesus, Lokra daga zombra zekataya. As a ministry, we come before you this Wednesday. Likla daga zombra zekataya. That you can make us a sign and a wonder, oh God. Make this ministry a sign and a wonder in this nation. Make us a sign and a wonder in this nation, oh God. Father, in the name of Jesus, cause us to be a sign and a wonder. Cause us to be a sign and a wonder. Cause the ministers in this ministry, oh God, to be sign and wonders, oh God. I pray for all the families in this ministry that, Father, in the name of Jesus, cause them to be signs and wonders, oh God. I pray for all the ministers, the servants of the Most High God. Father, let your word be performed, oh God. Fulfill your word according to Kadesh Zaleva Sikataya. Let your word be fulfilled, oh God. Father, Lord, you said that this is a month for signs and miracles and wonders. I pray for miracles, signs, and wonders. And all the pastors, oh God, and all the ministers, Lord. Ragazimra Razika Taya Zonde Kazili Kataya. Legla Dagazomra Zika Taya Gazonde Kazika Taya. I want you to just guide and pray that, Father, release the anointing for the miracles, signs, and wonders in our ministry. In the name of Jesus, Raka Zombra Zikataya. Father God, we pray for our apostle Ssuuna, oh God. Father, cause him to be a sign and a wonder in this nation. In the name of Jesus, Liga Lebra Zekataya. As Lord, you say that this is our month for miracles, signs, and wonders, oh God. Let the anointing of signs and wonders, oh God, be upon his life. Leka Zonde Levazia Deka Sigatara. Rova Sida Kasubra Zekataya. Let there be miracles, signs, and wonders. In the name of Jesus. And in the power of the Holy Spirit. We are going to pray this one prayer point for this service. It is Acts chapter 5. As I welcome the men of God. Acts chapter 5. The Bible says, by their hands he did miracles, signs, and wonders. That is the scripture I want us to pray for. As we declare miracles, signs, and wonders upon this service. In the name of Jesus. Acts chapter 5. Verse 12, the Bible says, and by the hands of the apostles were many signs and wonders wrought among the people. Praise be to the Most High God. We are going to declare that, Father, let there be miracles, signs, and wonders. As the men and the women of God declare the word of God in this service. As the men of and the women of God declare the oracles. Let there be miracles, signs, and wonders. As the women and the men of God are here to, I want you to declare, speak a miracle and a wonder. Starting from your miracle, whatever miracle you need. But the Bible says, by the hands of the apostles. When the apostles gather in this place, I want you to declare miracles, signs, and wonders to be done starting from your life in the name of Jesus. Father, we declare miracles, signs, and wonders in this service. Let there be miracles, wonders, oh God. Father, as the women of God dwell here, as the men of God are here to release the oracles, let there be miracles, signs, and wonders in the name of Jesus. Father, we release the grace for miracles. We release the glory for miracles. We release the anointing for miracles, signs, and wonders in this very service. And I declare that every man and every woman in this service, you will live with your miracle. You will live with your healing. You will live with your that grace you need. That anointing you need will come upon your life before the end of this service. In the name of Jesus. And if you are waiting expectantly for that miracle, just go ahead and clap your hands. Just go ahead and clap your hands. As we honor the men and the women of God in the house, just go ahead and clap your hands. Clap your hands, clap your hands, clap your hands, clap your hands. As we honor the men and the women of God to take us in the next session. In the name of Jesus. Just go ahead and clap your hands.
Dominion Assemblies International, a home of the supernatural, a place to be. Welcome to Dominion Assemblies International, where we minister love to a hurting world, bring life to dead situations, and preach the infallible word of God. We are located at 267 Moody Street, Suite 201, Waltham, Massachusetts. Dominion Assemblies is a ministry headed by Apostle Henry E Ssuuna, an anointed man of God, a man after God's own heart, a loving man, and a father of nations. At Dominion Assemblies, we are open 24/7. Join us in our weekly power-packed programs, which run as follows. Enjoy our morning glories, which run from Monday to Friday, 6:30 to 8 a.m. Our lunch hours also running from Monday to Friday, 1 to 2 p.m. Join our midweek services for Bible study every Wednesday, 6:30 to 9 p.m. Charge your spirit in our midnight hour of prayer every Tuesday and Thursday, 11:45 to 1 a.m. Encounter God as you talk to Him one-on-one in our extraordinary Friday overnight, where we have more of prayer and less of preaching, 8 p.m. to 11 p.m. Entrust us with your children in the missing link with the Dominion Divine Children every Saturday, 11 a.m. to midday, and the Dominion Teens every Saturday in their program, The Safe Heavens, from 5 to 6 p.m. Join us for worship in our life-changing services where miracles happen.
Jesus in your life goes deeper, gives you the victory, transforms everything concerning you. You cease to be ordinary.
Our main service starts at 10 and ends at 1 p.m. And our evening services, where we lift up our praises, worship, and testify for what God has done. We have the Dominion Virtuous Women meeting every Tuesday from 5 p.m. to 7 p.m. Do not forget to follow us.
We are going to hear from the servant of God. She's going to teach us. She's going to speak to us, and she's going to pray for us. In the name of Jesus Christ, the Son of the Living God. Hallelujah.
Glory to our lovely Father.
Now get prepared.
You can share
this link to somebody.
To
the glory of God. In Jesus' gracious name. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Glory.
Mama, we are happy to see you. Now you can have the flow. Pastor Rachel.
We are very happy to see you, Msumba Rachel.
Hallelujah. I know it has been a long day for both of you. Many people have been waiting for you. They want to hear from the Lord. And they want to be counseled by you. We want to hear from you, Mama. Amen.
Amen. Come on, favors.
Praise our lovely Jesus.
Yeah,
we thank God for today. He has given us a blessing to be before Him. And we thank God for the grace of God. We honor the anointing and the woman of God that came first and the brethren that are in this place. We believe the hand of God to be in this place. Let the name of God be glorified. In the name of Jesus.
Come from Lungi Evers.
Praise our lovely Jesus.
To see Makatonda,
appreciate God this evening.
To ever Zamukama.
We dearly thank God.
Because
God has been good.
We
thank Him. He has brought us in this place. We thank Him. Because of you that is listening. Tonight, we are believing God that your life is not going to remain the same. We are here on the panel. But we are waiting eagerly to hear and to drink of the anointing. To hear the prophet of God. To hear what God is doing. To hear what is God telling us. A brethren, the entire world is on, waiting to hear what God is going to do. From the start of this week, Mommy preached a song here. It was on Sunday. About anointing. We've been talking about anointing. We've been talking about anointing.
But today, we've come back.
Most especially tonight.
Mama is going to talk to us.
Ministering unto our lives.
In the name of Jesus Christ. The Son of the Living God. But before she comes, I want to inform you. The great God. The God of David. We've been talking about David. And we discovered that David, after being obedient, after each and everything, David was anointed. And the anointed made him someone. We discovered today what you are talking about, the title that we are talking about, we are talking about the God. We are talking about the minister. We are talking about obedience. We are talking about waiting upon God. Honoring God.
That
every time you honor the anointing, every time you honor the servant of God, every time you go back and honor God, God elevates you and honors you.
Because David never knew.
David never knew that in that obedience and remaining God was put. He was putting on a kingship anointing. He was not born knowing that he's going to be a king. But because of obedience, the anointing brought him. The anointing established him. I'm here to tell you today, as we are moving ahead tonight, there is anointing that is going to make you. When you talk about Moses, Moses served God. Moses was prepared. But after that, we see Joshua comes to serve Moses. After serving Moses, and God promoted him. Every anointing that you serve, every time you serve God, he's going to take you somewhere. There is an office that is going to plant you in. We've come to speak unto your life. That don't fear any situation. Don't fear what the ministry says. Don't fear what the people say. Don't fear what is there. Don't fear any disease. The anointing of God. When it comes down, it takes away diseases. It takes away all the bondages. Because of that, I'm here as a voice. But allow me to welcome Mother, the one that I'm welcoming.
I'm so proud. For she is my mother, my mentor. She has made me. I'm made now. I'm ready to fly. Because
I served the anointing, and I am still serving. The scripture is in Hebrews chapter 10. It says that when we served the well one to God, and we are still serving the saints, I need that scripture, please. Hebrews chapter 10.
Yes, Lord, my God. In the name of Jesus. Tonight, you're not going to remain the same. Tonight, you're going to win. Allow me.
Sir,
I don't waste time. I'll come back later. But I cannot speak. The one that I'm
saying.
The one that I'm introducing unto you.
There
is the horn of anointing upon us that transforms destinies. Our destinies have changed because of the anointing. Here, the people that are in the congregation, let us walk out. The anointing in the name of Jesus. I kindly ask of you to stand up. Come on, shout. So that you will come, the woman of God, in the name of Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Glory.
Amen. Come on, favors.
Praise our lovely Jesus.
We are
in the presence of God.
We are
going to talk.
We are
going to talk about anointing. Everyone, you can ask a question. Why do people fail? How can someone move on? How can we be the men and women of God? Because we've been talking about the anointing that breaks every yoke. We want to share. We are going to pray at the end of the service. But whoever, you don't have peace and you came in this place, God is going to put right your life
in
the name of Jesus. Pastor, what were you saying?
Hallelujah.
Glory.
Praise the living God.
When you started, I don't want to come.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
People have a lot of questions.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Most
of them, they say we've served God
for many times.
They've said many years. But in
me,
I've served everything that I could. But there is nothing that I show. They are very many.
People are very frustrated.
Being Christians, there is no difference between a Christian and a non-Christian. But there is a, when there is a difference, like you have served God
for quite a long time,
when
you have experienced these things,
what can you tell us, Mama?
Okay,
praise our lovely Jesus.
Paul says the
thoughts that run
fast.
But there is one that gets a reward. You cannot give yourself marks. It is those people that see you that give you marks. Are the children of today or the ministers? They have given themselves marks. They're having pity upon themselves. They see that they have done a lot. Someone can tell you, I've been there for you. But when they came to minister, you cannot be there for me. When you are all running, we are running on the relay. We are all going somewhere. I hand over the stick and you run too. But what I want to tell you, the works that you are doing, there is a reward. The Bible says there is a big reward. Me, Pastor
Namtevi,
it is the people that say, I've worked a lot. But I don't know how it is with God. Sometimes what we call the works of God, God chooses. The Bible says on that day, he's going to separate the sheep from the goats and the bears.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
He's
going to differentiate. He's going to separate the rude food.
Hallelujah.
He will separate the plant from the bush
then
and his own seeds. Now you cannot say that I've worked a lot when it's the people that have to say that you've worked and God. Every time you're going to another level, when you're going up, there are many things that happen to fight you. Every time we are on a go, watch us that God has called you to get a lot of enemies, to be fought left, right, and center. They are fighting you here and there. They are fighting you. They are fighting you all around. Then you've started your journey. But all in all, we have to work and give ourselves in. Our battles pass through people. They come from people. But the enemy uses people also. We don't have to get tired. We just have to keep on going. The God that called us is the God that knows our word. He knows that we've worked a lot. The Bible says, our Lord said this word, that if they tell you that thank you for serving, say that we are unworthy servants. That is what God sent us to do. Amen. It's not what we've done. Some of us know that we are ministers. But what God has sent us to do is not what we are doing. We've done things to please ourselves, to please people. We've pleased ourselves and we think that we've done. But the Bible says the God that sits in heaven sees the works that we've done and is the God that rewards them. Every time you start doing the works of God, God anoints you more and more. And the anointing he gives you, it is going to break the yokes.
In Matthew,
God tells the disciples, he told Peter, Peter, you are a rock. And I'll build my church on that rock. And the power of hell, they're not going to prevail. Why did he tell Peter? Because he asked him, well, how do people call me? He used to ask him, how do people call me? People are asking, what? Amen. John the Baptist. Amen. You called him whatever he wants. Prophet. But you people that are with me, how do you call me? Only Peter. You are Jesus Christ, say that, the Son of the living God. That flesh and blood has not revealed it to you, but our Father in heaven has revealed it unto you. When you get a revelation in your life, in your ministry, God builds a ministry upon your life. God gets the ministry and put it on your life because you've gotten the revelation and you have people in the ministry. Sometimes they don't have a revelation. In seeking God, you get revelation. The more you desire, God opens your eyes and then you see our Father. And God builds upon your ministry. And now the ministry God puts on you, the Bible says, even the witchcraft or demons, they cannot prevail upon us.
Hallelujah.
Glory.
Praise the living God. I believe, oh mama, thank you so very much.
Praise the lovely Jesus.
Katonda yawa. Rewarding.
It is God that rewards.
Praise
the lovely Jesus. We share a lot of things with many people. I've done everything that God has told me all these years. But I don't see anything to show. Amen. Praise the lovely Jesus. But God, let us serve God. And God, as Mama said,
oh, thank you, that you must be
You have to get a revelation of that for you to understand it. And you serve God.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And the reward I will never forget
to
the glory of God in Jesus' gracious name. Hallelujah.
If there are people there,
yesterday, send in your prayer requests, send in your questions,
come on favor. Amen.
Amen.
Now we are talking about the anointing.
Amen. Amen.
Amen. With the title that God gave it. Amen. To discuss. Amen. Talking about David. But on Sunday you said something.
A rema word came.
And the Lord told you, is there anyone that is left? In the house of Nathaniel.
Nathan, right mukama yalonya.
What? Why did God choose?
Oya sigadeo mu nyumba ya
that one
ya
that Saul. Had remained in Saul's house.
Kura Nathan.
For Jonathan's sake. Amen.
Nathan ateko kubanga aline chintu echenja uloche yakola.
He must have done something different or special.
Mumaso ga katona.
Before the Lord.
Ateko kubanga aline chenja uloche
yakola. There must be something special that he did.
The Dawudi.
That David. It was revealed unto him
after many years
to
look for this young man for the house of Saul.
There must be someone that is left that had to sit on this seat with me.
Throne.
Amen.
This is what I think.
Every time we do a godly thing and we serve God, we might not see it now.
It is a seed.
As God gave it unto you, there must be a reason as to why.
Praise the living.
Amen.
Amen.
Praise our lovely
Jonathan.
Jesus. Jonathan.
Yari musari kuruwa Daudi.
He gave himself for David's life.
He was a helper.
In each and every situation that David was in, Jonathan was there for him. Jonathan was killed in a war because he became last. To see that he saves or protects David. Now David, that is why David went at David. And he said, is there anyone that is left in Saul's house for Jonathan's sake so that I show him kindness? The shedding of the blood, the sacrifice that Jonathan gave him, it was added unto him to be blessed. Now when God releases a blessing, it comes unto us and unto our children. It comes unto us and our families. There was a blessing of Jonathan. David said, I'm not going to forget Jonathan because he has been there for me. He has protected me. Jonathan kept the anointing that was upon David. He protected it in a different way, special way. Chechuachi came and said, is there anyone left? In releasing the anointing and the glory of God and the presence of God and the revelations of God, there is one thing that I want to tell you. Every time you give yourself because of the man of God or the woman of God, every time you give yourself for the house of God, God is not going to forget you with your house and your children. The anointing that was put on David, it had also to go to Jonathan because they were together. They were working together. They made a covenant or an oath. Amen. With David. And they took vows that your children shall be mine and mine shall be yours. You eat together with me. I will eat with you. And Jonathan left. Now David goes back to fulfill that covenant of Jonathan. Minister that is here, people might not understand you, but God is going to understand you.
They might not see what you're doing, but the heaven is seeing. Every time you walk where you are, there is a heaven that is coming with you. People who want to make you happy or please you. Amen. They feel they're discouraged. In the entire world, that is how the ministry is. Don't serve people. You serve God. God is going to come back to reward you. He's going to look at the works that you've done. And God will reward you according to what you've done. Jonathan was not around, but his children had to share, take a portion of it. Amen. They did give Ziba anything. Ziba was a servant. But Metho was Jonathan's child. He was also included in the covenant of David. Even if Jonathan had died, but the covenant that they did oath, it goes to the children, the grandchildren, and the children of the children. I want to speak unto you who is listening. Everything you do in the house of God, it is going to go upon your children. It is going to go in your house. It is going to go where you work from. It is going to go where you sit. The hand of God is going to be upon your life. Amen. Amen. The covenant of God. We are ministers. Amen. We've just gotten born again. Amen. The characters from where we come from. Sometimes we don't appreciate, but the heavens appreciate. Every time God sees you, you've given your life in the house of God. You've become a Jonathan because of his work. You've become a Jonathan because of the work of God. God is going to provide for you. God is going to bless you. And everything that crippled is going to become straight in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Praise the living God. Come on, favors.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Glory.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Oh, come on, favors.
Praise the lovely Jesus.
What were
someone has a question.
Praise the living God. Come on, favors.
Praise our lovely Jesus. There is a question here.
Nti Pastor Namtevi.
Musumba Namtevi.
How have you been able to stay on fire for God all these years? What is the secret?
Secondly,
you speak of the Holy Spirit.
Good handwriting.
Amen.
Praise the living God. And let's get a microphone.
Hallelujah.
Glory to our lovely Jesus.
Praise God.
Praise Jesus.
Hallelujah. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Lord, as they're still asking,
how
can we keep the fire? How can we keep that fire of God? Praise the lovely Jesus. That the problems and the situation, they could bring you to pray. To stand before God. To surrender yourself. My life is a life of prayer. My life is a life of fasting. My life is a life of being before the Lord. Things are not easy. Every time you feel you can't sleep, the situations come, and this one also
arrives.
But God Almighty, He gives you the time to come closer to Him. As you see this daily altar, every time you're on the altar, every insect that is upon you, it burns. Every situation, every spirit, a bad spirit, even if it's a habit it can burn. Now every time you leave the fire burning, you, even in your life you keep on, every time we have to lead that fire. Not today only, and also Sunday. Amen. You find the fire would burn. But there is prayer all the time. Amen. First. Amen. I don't pity myself. If you do that, you're going to fail. Secondly, I don't listen to people that have pity upon me. Sorry. That person that says sorry all the time. It is good they're helping you, but they cause you to be on material down. There is one pastor who is in South Africa. He was called Pastor Vutavwachi. He's in South Africa. He used to tell me,
"Why don't you rest? Why don't
you rest?"
South Africa, abantu baga re re, bako sanyo re.
Baugera nyobwe batyo.
Praise
the lovely Jesus.
Why don't you rest?
Rachito umula.
Ayagala umule.
He wants you to rest.
Na yoku umula ko umula.
But the resting that you get rest, even the anointing rests.
Buliro umula.
Every time you rest,
Katonda ali mbulambo ga umula.
The God that is in your life rests.
Zemeje mu America ko umula.
I came in America to rest. And other things that brought me here. But I feel that every time you rest, inside you, you grow cold. You grow cold every time. Amen. At home, they're praying. I pray here. It causes me to put on the service or to put on Joshua. Amen. I make the volume loud. And I lit a fire in my life. And I start praying. Amen. To awaken my inner person. That person that serves God. The children of God that are watching. You don't have to pity yourself. Don't allow that person that comforts you, that causes you to rest. You don't have to rest. Jesus spoke this word, and he said the foxes have the, where they put their head, but a son of man has nowhere to put his head. Jesus, where do you sleep? Where do you stay? He said that the foxes or the wolves have where they put their head. He was not meaning that. He was talking to people. If you've ever read about the fox, it is always sleeping. It is always sleeping. They have where they put their head. But a son of man has nowhere to put his head. We don't have to sleep. We don't have to rest. Until Jerusalem becomes a praise.
That's why Bible.
The Bible says those that remind God, don't get tired. Don't rest. Until when Jerusalem has become a praise.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Glory to our lovely Jesus.
Praise the living God.
Mm. Amen. Praise Jesus. We don't have to rest.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Praise our lovely
Amen.
Jesus. The people that say that Jesus called us to rest. Jesus did pay the price.
No.
He worked for us.
Yes,
that is not what he said.
That's why Ephesians,
he says that let us stand. We don't wrestle with the flesh and blood, but with the principalities. Every time you're saved, you've opened a war. At the moment you get saved, now you've opened a war zone. When you start serving, you've opened a war zone. You go into ministry, and you step in a place that is significant. You've opened the
wound.
You have to fight. We don't fight or boxes, but we fight in the spiritual realm. Every time you pray, you go deeper. The reason as to why you're fighting is not flesh, but those are the spirits that are fighting against you. Someone has said, the scripture says, come unto you all that are tired, heavy laden, and I'll give you rest. But I think it is different from reading the Bible and get a revelation that Jesus makes.
Yesu zendoza ndiyari itabakoye abakoya bayina emigugu
abayina
Yesu
teri kuhumula kubanga ne Yesu mission
iyo jimaliriza
for him to accomplish his mission he did not trust
Yesu
yakowa Jesus got tired
Yesu yagamba
Jesus said
ntichitange
that my father
asaba
amen praise
ali kumusala bakulukumpe
amen
agamba chitange
my father
obachi yinzika
if it is possible
chikompe chino
take away
chinzijibwe
ko from me
chitegeza na yeye yakowa na
yeye
teyakowa
but he did not get tired
kuna kuumuza Yesu kwagamba
the rest thing that Jesus said
una mpereza WhatsApp agamba ndi Yesu yagamba
Jesus said
mujeje ndi abakoti
come on to me
over that
and have they learned and I'll give you
rest
I feel answering you that is so because it takes away the sorrow it takes away poverty it takes away all the diseases it takes away other diseases but as we come as mama said we come to serve we've carried the cross so that we follow Jesus we've not come to rest in church
in fact
I discovered something all the Christians
oba walokosejjo
whether I got one
walokoseruri
oba
oli wa mwaka
buli
muntu yena mu church
everyone in church
pastor
they have to do something
everyone
has a
na yo kuumula kudiwa
but there is no resting in salvation that's what I feel praise our lovely Jesus Matthew 10:1 the Bible says that he called the disciples he gave them authority over
the bad spirit
he was teaching them the way they were going to fight he called them and he added on the women of God and the men of God he called them and he gave them the power and authority upon all the demons
amen naba sindika bagende
and he tells them to go
naba fuwako
the Bible says it put his spirit you don't go with two clothes or shoes go with a rod only this God that you serve
is Petro Yokana naba langa baigiriza ministry bwe
he was teaching them how the ministry is praise our lovely Jesus
kati amanya guge yabawa
now the power I gave them amen is to fight with each and every problem and no situations
chino chebagamba Yesu bwe yatuita
when Jesus called us
yatumuza
he gave us
eliemizimu
unto demons
yembe,
unto all those spirits
yebitega,
unto all those spirits and this kind of resting there is no condemnation those that are in Jesus Christ because the word of the cross made them free now if we don't have any condemnation we are free to go to the Father when we say that let us go to pray amen all the children of God everyone starts to pray in others sit others stand others laugh because we are free there is no condemnation Jesus took the condemnation but when the condemnation goes away and let us go now that came and took away amen now there is no condemnation because the word of the cross made us free
but
if you don't have the cross the Bible says in Isaiah amen those that remind Jesus you and me and we are the reminders of the Lord that never get tired do not rest praying and seeking God until when Jerusalem who is Jerusalem you are Jerusalem she is Jerusalem he is Jerusalem until when it becomes a praise never get rest don't sleep until when Jerusalem has become a praise the person who saw me when I used to put on sandaka I used to
let God borrow
amen I was not educated sina chendi as you see amen but me coming out a praying I don't rest I don't sleep until when Jerusalem that was is in my life will become a praise everywhere you pass they say the woman of God is there hey mchala wakatonda mchala wakatonda now Jerusalem comes out people start seeing Jerusalem the Bible says that you are my temple
where the Spirit of God sits. I am good, that's what he says. I sit in the midst of your lies. And lastly, I've called you God's word. But whatever you speak is going to come to pass. Amen.
Now,
God does not sit in the air of space. God sits in Jerusalem. God is always in Jerusalem. You and me, sister, we have to keep ourselves, to keep our Jerusalem, to be holy. Jerusalem, to be a praise everywhere we are.
Wow. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Glory, whoever it is. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Glory.
So we must not rest.
Yes. As the children of God. Now when we come in Christ, we've launched a war unto the enemy. We do not have to rest. Reminding our God what he has spoken unto us, what he has done in us.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Until when we become a praise. Praise our lovely Jesus. Can we clap for Jesus?
In the name of Jesus
Christ.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Yes.
Ask a
question.
Amen. Thank you, Holy Spirit.
Pastor, we thank you so much for the opportunity for learning from you. Pastor, you speak of the Holy Spirit with a closeness. And it seems like you have a deep relationship with the Holy Spirit. Have you been able to build that relationship with him?
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
The relationship with the Holy Spirit, first of all, we cannot make ourselves holy, but we can hate sin. Sin,
that sin
has separated you from God. God sits in our lives.
That
day we get saved, God pass his peace on us. But every time we pray more, we came here cold. But the more we speak, you feel that heat coming out of your life. It means that the Holy Spirit is rising inside of you. Because the scriptures say that I will rise in you like a lion. And I will roar unto the world. The more the Holy Spirit is with you or within you,
this
God, the powerful God is the Holy Spirit. He arises inside of you. Everywhere you pass, he roars like a lion. He fights with all the situations that are fighting with you. But to keep the Holy Spirit, you have to pray so much. Secondly, we have to get away from all that stumble us. When you get saved, situation comes. If you're a girl, men come. If you're a man, that is when women come to you. Many things come to you. When you get born again, God puts favor on you.
When I
get, it's not how I am now. People tell me you look good. You become someone different. The glory of God comes upon you. But even the devil brings people to you.
Words,
the words that are
brings.
But every time when you wake up, you come against the plan of the enemy. Sometimes you close your eyes, you see an old dog. You get to know that the spirit of immorality. When you're praying, you see cats passing. If you are touching people's stuff, you see that spirit of stealing. When we are in outer Romoyo, we start to uproot, especially the habits that were in me, because as a human being, the habits that were following me, that's what I start with before I start to someone, because I know myself. I had anger, I used to lie, hatred was in me, and all the other spirits that attack you. Now you start attacking them. You fight with each and every one. I'm a child of God. When you speak such, God is in your life. When we speak, you wake up. A person that is in you, the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. Amen. He starts to come up in the midst of your life. The Holy Spirit arises.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Now when he arises in your life, he helps you. That is why he said we do not wrestle with flesh and blood, but with the principalities. After fighting with that, God starts to reveal unto you. Someone is coming and then you hit them too. You also hit that hatred.
Amen.
The spirit of gossiping in church, you hit that. You're always on the battle. But the problem we have, we fight with all the demons from afar. But where we come from, there are those spirits that come to attack us. Amen. I'm in a big church. Amen. All the people that come in church are not perfect. But someone can be a gospel. Someone that speaks words to destroy the church and confuse. But she is not the one. That is a spirit behind. He doesn't need to be hated. Now, if you've been revealed unto it, you get the spirit. I've come against the spirit. I hit it. I break it. Because she or he does not know. It has never been revealed unto him or her. But you that has been revealed unto it, you start with that and pray. Now the spirit of God grows slowly by slowly. God strengthens you. God gives you the grace. Amen. He awakens you. Go to the toilet. When you go to the toilet for short call, and the Holy Spirit tells you, start praying.
What?
Amen. The Holy Spirit has warned you. Start praying. Then you find yourself praying in Kampala. It is not far from the city. The people that are praying, you hear different churches praying. Even you hear Muriro, and you ask yourself, I've been sleeping. Amen. You lead each other. We don't have to call a baby service. But you have to pray. The altar hits the enemy. The altar that never goes down, it overcomes. Amen. In the lives of people, they are powerful. Amen. I don't know whether I've answered you.
Hallelujah.
Praise the living God.
Praise the lovely Jesus.
Amen.
Before
we are in prayer group,
we are now. Now we've gotten to know God. Let us
light
a fire by the time you come on the altar with others, let us light an altar. Your altar is already lighted. If there is firewood on your altar, it can also ignite others that have altars that are down.
Point.
And most of our brethren, but you have to be prayerful. People. Pastor Rachel, wake up. Some of them are seated, some of them are standing. Online. We can have a network. Amen. All of us are going to pray. And we start praying. Amen. And we hit the enemy. This body, the flesh. It is the flesh. The Bible says that the Lord is coming for a church that has no wrinkle. Amen. The people that have seen that have kept themselves. Amen. They're always powerful. There is a fire inside of them that never goes down. Because the one that is in you never stumbles. If the Holy Spirit stumbles himself, he goes away. He goes away. We have to keep ourselves when the fire is lit up.
Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Praise the living God.
Musumba.
Pastor.
Tulino kwekuma.
We have to keep ourselves.
Tulino kutambula nga tuliba kutukovu.
We have to move.
Tulino kuchawe ekibi.
We have to hate sin.
Niyo ogambye.
But you've said.
Nti. Tuli bantu.
That we are human beings.
We have our, there is a pastor friend of mine.
Waliwo musumba mukwano kwange.
I don't know what happened to him.
Simancha mbako.
But the little I know.
Naye katono kemanyi.
What happened to him was not the best.
Sichali chirunje.
Come on, favor zwe.
He's a lovely Jesus.
And neye nava mubantu. Nava mukanisa mpola.
He left church slowly by slowly.
Nava mubufumbo.
He also left the marriage.
Navula na neye nga yeye judginga.
He was judging himself.
Ngavo yogera na ya gamba mnangi.
When you talk to him, he used to say.
Agamba chino chechabao.
This is what happened.
Chino chechabao.
This is what happened.
Nenga nzikiriza nti teli chivichona.
I believe there is no sin.
Teli ngavo itulibantu.
As we are human beings,
we can fall short of the glory.
Tusobola kuva mchitiwa.
Nayo omusumboyo.
But that pastor.
Oba omulokoloyo.
Or that Christian.
Oba fena.
All of us.
Nga owanguddwa.
When you've been beaten.
Ensi netandiko kukondeminga.
And the world starts condemning. Naye
okoze otya oyambye otya omuntu oyo oba tweyambye tutya.
How are we going to help ourselves?
Okukomawo.
To come back. When you've fallen short of
Katonda,
the
glory.
We've stumbled with the Holy Spirit and has he left for good? Amen. And God is not using us anymore.
You know, according to your experience.
Yeah, okay. Come
on,
favor.
Praise our lovely Jesus. The Bible says, let us not give the enemy any space.
HB,
the sin is always sin.
The Bible says,
the enemy, when the enemy comes, amen, you pack up,
you
will flee from you. Amen. Now what we have to do in our lives, that we are human beings. But Jesus knew that we can overcome. Not every day. One thing I know about God, as me upon my life, you have to keep an anointing. The more you keep yourself, the more the anointing. That's a secret. Let me try. Amen. So can testify. There are many things that confuse you. And I come, I attack them. You hear the Holy Spirit telling you. You feel the Holy Spirit has left you. Sometimes I say, forgive me. You have to walk with God. But he is in wrong. But I'm looking for that person that sits upon my life to come back. Praise the lovely Jesus. When you're coming to service, people have annoyed you. You feel you can't feel the Holy Spirit at all. Because the Bible says it's like a dove. I'm going to keep myself. Whether someone has done a mistake, don't tell me anything that is going to annoy me. Why? When you annoy the Holy Spirit like this, he's not going to remain. Let us not put a smear Vaseline on sin. Sin is sin. In all sins, the Bible says all sins are equal. But immorality, amen, comes to church a lot. Now, if immorality comes to ministry, it is very hard. The Bible says there is a sin that stumbles. That's of immorality. It is tangible. It is seen on you. It sits in the heart. That immorality.
not even a man and a woman. But there is something that you see, it overtakes you more than God. Something that can help us is to keep ourselves in prayer. The more you pray, the more the enemy comes to you. But even though he has attacked you, you can overcome because you have to decide. I just give an example. You cannot stand there and someone comes and opens your pants. You can't. As that person is coming, you tell them, go away. They go. Now, I'm making a decision. It is very near you. A person cannot come and touch you. You tell them, go away. You've hit the enemy. Sometimes the enemy comes. Amen. He wins the flesh. It sleeps. Amen. It becomes sweet. Sweet. It becomes good. And the eyes become
true.
You feel your heart is taken. You're not going to pray. You're not going to be before the Lord. You find yourself. Now, after you going away, you start judging yourself. You go afar. But as we are before God today, every day we need to pray. What helped me as I was a youth, and I was a Christian, I got saved when I was 16, up to today. I refused to sleep in the house alone. Even if you ask Pastor Rachel, Pastor Rachel used to sleep at my place. Now, if you sleep in the house alone, many things come unto you, even thoughts. Temptations also come. I used to be in groups of people. I go and sleep at church. I call a young girl's group. Until when I become a mighty woman. Until when I got married. Amen. Let us try to go away from things that cause us to sin. Sin fights with the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit stumbles. The Bible says that when he comes in your house, he comes in and cleans it. But after him going, the enemy comes and fights a clean house. And he brings those giants 7 times 7. Those that are more powerful than the first ones. But how are we going to win when we are praying all the time? First of all, let the Holy Spirit be upon your life. Secondly, amen. Be humble unto the anointing. Now, if you're not humble, it is the anointing that is going to help you. The Bible says God is fire. God will help us. Those are the things that we've escaped from. But we've escaped from that. They have attacked us and we've escaped. We've also escaped from many things. They wanted us to fight, but we've escaped. Every time you remember how it's going to, what will God say? What will God say? God helps you.
Hallelujah. Praise the living God. Let
us clap for Mama.
These are the
things that we encounter as Christians, as amen, ministers.
These
are the things that are going to help us to overcome. The devil does not fear. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Glory.
Alumba buli muntu.
He attacks everyone. Amen.
Ne mama.
But mother, the person that is being, you've told us how we can keep ourselves. Amen, to escape.
No,
and to escape.
Na ye
now we are talking about the person that is
overcome.
How does that person come back? That one that is beaten.
Otia.
How can you bring him or her back? How do you come back as you that is being beaten down? You are
Saint Gambie. The
Holy Spirit stumbles
and
you feel you can't hear the Holy Spirit anymore in you.
connected.
No more with the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
You feel that you've gone far. You're going far.
Hallelujah. Amen.
You don't want to come to church anymore. You don't want to pray anymore. When you see anyone born again, you hide. You look at people, you think they're judging you. Amen.
Amen.
How do you help yourself? There is someone that is listening. They're in their houses. But they are saying, I want to go back. But what should I do? We read a scripture about David. That even your children, amen, they will wrong me. They will annoy me. But I'll bring them back. I'm going to bring them back. It is only God that brings back. The Bible says that I've put help upon a mighty person. Talking about David, the way he loved him. But he talks that even your children, they will annoy me. They're going to do unworthy things. I'll punish them, but I'll bring them back. Now, if a person has gone out of God's glory, but they are still confessing Jesus, Jesus will help them.
Christ
will bring them back. Jesus can help that person. But not every time. You do it and you say, Pastor Namtebi said God will have mercy. He will have mercy upon the grandchildren of David. Who knows that you are grandchild of David? David was talking about his covenant because he gave sacrifices. Praise the lovely Jesus. And he said, I will never leave you. I will never leave your children. Even if they annoy me, I will punish them, but I will bring them back. Now we have to pray for one thing, for God to bring back the children of God. Another thing, the one that mocks Jesus will be forgiven. Amen. The one that will never be forgiven. We have to keep the Holy Spirit. Amen. You've gotten a hajj. And he asks you, how do you pray? I felt you, I heard you speaking in tongues. We are always there, sakataka. You're with your chiman, your hajj, and you're blaspheming the Holy Spirit. You get the things of, amen, you also mock the man of God or woman of God. You blaspheme them. I don't judge. But the scripture says, whoever blasphemes Jesus will be forgiven. But if you blaspheme the Holy Spirit, you'll never be forgiven.
Amen.
Amen. This is what I think, Pastor. Amen.
The Bible says, Chronicles, Musambundo Zakuminanya.
Bible Yegama. The Bible says,
Abantu bangi,
if my people,
Abatumi Dwerinya,
who are called by my name,
to Omuntu Yasoka Namanyanti Natumi Dwerinya,
that person has to know that our Lord, Wanga Woloko
Kachitegezo Fusemuchi,
becomes the local Mazoku Tumi Dwerinya. Now you have the name that if they humble themselves,
Neva Saba,
and they pray,
Neba nonya maso gange.
And they seek my face. Amen. I see things that can keep someone. They heal, they help you. They bring you back. Even if you fail, what brings you back? Even if you're immoral, what brings you back? Even if you stole, what brings you back? You have to recognize
it.
And you get to know that truthfully, I was given the name of Jesus. I'm a Christian. If they humble themselves and pray, and you give yourself in prayer,
because this is a decision,
they humble themselves and pray, and they seek my face. It means that when we get born again, one of the things that keep us with the Holy Spirit is to gather, is to surrender yourself, and they give their eyes, and they pray, and they sought my eyes, and they lift their bad acts.
After getting born again, people are falling short of the glory, but it is very easy to come back. You have to recognize, to know that you're saved. I failed, but I mean, it is still upon me. After that, accept. And you get to know, let me be humble before the Lord, dear Holy Spirit. I sinned before you, but I've come back unto you. Bring back the grace unto me. Bring back your spirit unto me. I don't feel you, Holy Spirit. Please come back. I feel.
Amen.
To help. To stand in salvation. To send the Holy Spirit. Amen. And it is the establishment of lives. That is why he says, in such a way, come, let's reason together. Amen. Even if your sins are
made.
Amen. He calls you to reason, to pray. How does a person fall short of the glory? The people that do not pray. Amen. Those people that are not in church anymore. Be careful if they have taken 2 months and they come back. You don't just go to them. Where have you been? When they look at you, just go away, walk away. It means they have come from afar, they are from afar. They beat you, they step on you, or they... They are not laughing anymore. Maybe they are coming from a man's house. Maybe they are pregnant. They might be something else. We have to be careful. You handle them slowly. They are very happy to see you. We've been missing you so much. You bring back their souls. The Bible says, come, let's reason together. Even if your sins are many. Amen. As blood, they shall be white. Amen. We have to come and reason with God, praying together. And the altar is going to help us to take away all those habits.
Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Glory to our lovely Jesus.
Praise the living.
We dearly thank God for this great moment that we are in.
Those are the best questions that
we had.
Simanyowa Pastor Jennifer Alina Chagamba. Come on, Fayebazu.
Alina, amen.
Katitu genda genda mkasela mama.
We're going to go in a moment.
Usabira abantu.
To pray for people.
Abantu bayo uliriza all over the world.
People listening most yonna.
People from India.
Avai India.
People from Malaysia.
I want to live in Malaysia.
People from UK. People from Liberty.
I want to have a Liberty.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
We see them.
Tuvalava.
Come on, favors.
I wish to
have a love on Namon Siona.
And all the people in the world.
Come on, favors.
Amen.
Echibuza Chich, same year.
The last question.
Chiba de Chiva, Dubai.
It came from Dubai.
Mumuntu yagwa.
A person fell short of God's glory. And he wants to come back.
Come on, favors.
He's a lovely Jesus.
Yeah, you get the binge if you just be cool, Musavire.
Amen. You pray for that
come
person.
Come on, favors.
Amen.
Nagambe biamusula na ye.
But
ayagalo kuda.
He wants to come back.
Come on, favors.
Praise the lovely
please
Jesus.
Tell pastor,
please he's tell calling
me.
You.
Amen. Please tell pastor to pray for me.
Gamba musumba
Musavire. I want to be restored.
Njagala kuzivao.
In the kingdom.
Mubaka vaka.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise the living God.
Amen.
We are going to pray.
Together,
Pastor, you can pray for the people.
Unless when Pastor Rachel has something to say, amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen. We have to keep ourselves in the grace of God. When we are like this, we have our brethren like that. They need to be supported. They need to be brought out. How do we do that? Prayer. When we are on the altar, we pray for people, even the members of those churches. Before the people sit in the chairs, we pray for them. By the time the person comes, their life is changed. The moment I entered the house, that my life changed. Because people are spirits, God can change them.
Let
Father, we thank you because you are an everlasting God. We thank you because you are powerful God. Thank you for the anointing. We thank you for your word. You are the God that is everlasting. We thank you because you are mighty God. Your glory, my God, let it cover. Father, you are fire. You are the God that takes away situations and problems. The God that takes away failure in the name of Jesus. We pray for our siblings, our brethren that are online. We pray for them that are in Uganda, that are in Dubai, that are in Asia, that are in Australia, that are in Germany, that are in Australia, that are in Sweden, that are in UK, those that are seated in America. We pray for the grace of God, the power of God. Father, your presence, you're the God of hosts. You're the God that opens the closed doors. You are the God that never fails. Lord, we thank you because you are mighty God. You can pray walking around. Our God is so mighty. Our God is mighty. Our God opens doors. Our God creates a way where there is no way. Our God takes away situations. Takes away failure today. Father, someone that has fallen short. Someone that has failed. The enemy has attacked them. Problems are going away, my God. Tortures, my God, are going out. You are the God that never fails. Your mighty hand is here. The grace of God is here. The visitation of God is available. My God, may you have mercy upon us in the abundance of your mercy. Have mercy upon your nation. Have mercy upon your people. Have mercy upon the people that are crying. Have mercy upon them, O God. Have mercy upon us, O God, we are not worthy. We ask of your hand to stand. You are the God of hosts, my God. Father, you're doing my miracles every day. We thank you because you are mighty God. Your power and your grace. You are the God that never fails, O God. Let your hand, my God, to manifest. Glorify yourself, mighty God. Glorify, mighty God, everlasting. Glorify yourself, the God that does things. I want you to win things that are take away all the failures. Take away the spirit of immorality that attacks people. My God, we take away disease of your name. We break every yoke, my God. We take away the power of darkness. We take away the power of witchcraft. All the demons that were following. The power of darkness. All the powers that come following. Father, all those old dogs. All those demons. The spirits that make people to stumble. All the spirit of gossiping. The spirit from the Bachwez. The spirit that follow. The spirit from the spirit of Uganda. The spirit of the Banyoro Jabatoro from the Barundi. The spirits of those in the name of Jesus. The spirits that come from the shrines. I come against them today in the name of Jesus. All the spirits that come from the shrines. All the demons that come from the shit. And the power of the enemy. And all the witchcraft. All the spirits. All the spirits that come from where we are born. Every power of darkness. Every work of the enemy devil. We overcome it today. We break it in the name of Jesus. We put them down under our feet. We overcome them in the name of Jesus. We break them in the name of Jesus. All things that break the church, that discourage the church. All the prince of the air, the prince of Persia, that reigns in the air, that seed in hell. We come against them in the name of Jesus. We break them in the name of Jesus. The spirit of suffering, the spirit of retaliation, the spirit of falling. I command that let it go in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, we release the fire. Amen. We release the fire of rejection and rejection. Release the fire unto being hated. Every master that the enemy covered you with breaking. The spirit that breaks the marriage, all the witchcraft, all the evil altars, people of God, amen, the one that is watching, the one that is listening, the one that is here today, witchcraft, I come against them, all the witchcraft of the enemy, the witchcraft, all the witchcraft, all the witchcraft of the enemy, the witchcraft of rejection, amen, that is upon your family, all those haters, that's where they sit, I send fire, we release
Bring us back in thy presence, O God. Bring us back in thy presence.
presence of God. Lord God Almighty, have mercy upon the body of Christ in the name of Jesus worldwide. Lord, have mercy upon the body of Christ to the glory of your name. Restore us. Bring us back, oh God, to the first love. To bring us back, oh God, in the name of Jesus. In thy presence, don't take away your presence, oh God. Don't take away your spirit from us. Lord, we pray, create a new heart in the name of Jesus. Create a new heart to the glory of your name in the name of Jesus. In our lives, Lord, we need you, King of Glory. Holy Spirit, Holy Spirit, may you, King of Glory, empower us, oh God. May you have mercy in the name of Jesus. Take your place in our lives, oh God. Take your place in our ministries, oh God. Take your place in our churches, oh God. Take your place in our homes, oh God. Take your place in the name of Jesus. From today, Lord, we choose, King of Glory, to walk with you, Lord, to lead us, oh God, in the name of Jesus. We shall follow you, Lord. We shall follow you, Lord. Spirit of the living God, we need you, Lord, more than before, Lord. We need you, King of Glory, in the name of Jesus. Merciful God, merciful God, this is the day, this is the night you have made for us, O God, in the name of Jesus, to return to you, in the name of Jesus. Have your way, King of Glory, have your way, my God, in the name of Jesus. Deliver us, O God, from every oppression of the devil, my God. Deliver us, O God, from every affliction of the devil, Lord, in the name of Jesus. Empower us to overcome the evil one, O God. Empower us, O God, to overcome the evil one, Lord. Empower us, Lord God Almighty, to overcome sin, O God. Empower us to overcome all the evil in the name of Jesus, to the glory of your name, by your precious blood, by your precious blood, by your covenant blood. Restore me, Lord. Restore us, O God, as a church, O God, as the body of Christ, worldwide, O God. Restore us in thy grace, O God, in thy presence, O God, in thy power, Lord, in thy love, O God, for the sake of your name, for the sake of your name, we humble ourselves as the body of Christ. We humble ourselves as leaders, O God. We humble ourselves as children of God. We humble ourselves, Lord God Almighty, to repent of our sins, where we have offended you, where we have offended you, where we have disobeyed you, in the name of Jesus, Lord. Have mercy, Lord. Have mercy, Lord. Have mercy, Lord. Have mercy, Lord. In the name of Jesus, restore us to the glory of your name. Heal us, O God, according to your name, according to your promise. You promised, O God, that you will heal the land. You will heal us, O God. When we return, Lord, we have returned as the body of Christ, as this church, O God, as members of Dominion, we have returned as individuals, O God, we have returned in the name of Jesus, to the glory of your name. Show up in our lives. You who is mighty, you who is in our midst, who is mighty to save, according to your word, may you save us, Lord. May you save somebody tonight. May you save us, Lord. May you save us, Lord. May you save us, Lord. In the name of Jesus, Lord, from sicknesses and diseases, from evil, my God, from sins, O Lord, in the name of Jesus, whatever had held us, whatever has held us, Lord God Almighty, let your precious blood break us under the bar. Let your Holy Spirit break it now. Deliver us now. In the name of Jesus, to the glory of your name, we dedicate ourselves. We dedicate our hearts. We dedicate our families. We dedicate our children. We dedicate this ministry. We dedicate this city. We dedicate all the members. We dedicate all the leaders. In the name of Jesus, to you, King of Glory, to you, Holy Spirit, in the name of Jesus, we dedicate this city.
We worship you, my God. We bless you, our God. We worship you, my God. We bless you, our 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 God. We b
the fire in our lives, in our houses, the fire where we stay, the fire where we stay, the fire in church, the fire in the ministry, the fire, 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 let anointing move, let anointing move, Release a blessing, release a glory of God, release the power of God, release the doors open, the blessing, we thank you for the anointing, my God. We thank you for the anointing, my God. I thank you, everlasting God. May you move among the people. May you, Father God, in the name, open the blind eyes, open the doors that were closed. Amen. Make a way where there's no way. Father God, we give our children. We give our children unto you. Father, the enemy is pointing fingers. The enemy is rising up against them. Father, fight with them that fight with our children. That fight with us. My God, our brethren, the youth of brethren are not praying. Let your mighty hand, O God, let your anointing be there. Father, open those open. Create a way there is no way. Let the hand of God be seen in the name of Jesus. Let pray the carrier. Thank you, Father. Father, deliver those that are watching. Deliver the online people. Even those that are just listening. Even those that will watch later. Even those that are problematic. Father, deliver the Dubai person. Father, bring him closer to your grace. All the children of God. Father, in America. Father, draw them near grace. Father, all the nations that are around. Father, in Arabic countries. Bring them closer. And the glory of God, let it manifest. In the name of Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Glory to our lovely Jesus.
Hallelujah. Put your hands together for the Lord. I appreciate God for what he has done. He's been in our midst. He's mighty to save. I believe he has saved him. In Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Father, we wish you blessed. We bless your name. We bless you, King of Glory. In Jesus' precious name. Hallelujah.
Glory.
Those, hallelujah,
amen,
who are going to give, those who are online, we thank you. We bless the name of the Lord for you. You are blessed. Our giving instructions are online. Give your best. Sow a seed in this anointing. Hallelujah. Glory. The Lord has restored us. The Lord has brought you back. Hallelujah. Don't be just a hearer of the word. Take the counsel.
We have heard from the word of God. You who had fallen away, the Lord has restored you in the name of Jesus. His love is still with you. Hallelujah. You can still do it again. He's going to do it again. He has washed you with his blood. You are restored. Begin from where you are. Come back to church in the name of Jesus Christ. Serve the living God. You'll be blessed to the glory of God. In Jesus' name. Father, we thank you. We bless you, King of Glory. May you bless your people. In Jesus' name, we have prayed. Amen and amen. Hallelujah. You can give your offering in Jesus' gracious name. Hallelujah. Glory. Hallelujah. Glory. Praise the living. The cash app is online. Zelle and all the giving instructions are online to the glory of God. In Jesus' gracious name. Hallelujah. Glory. Hallelujah. Like I said during the lunch of fellowship, summer is our season of evangelism. Praise the living God. We are going to go out as Dominion Assemblies to the glory of God. But we have our buses, praise the living God, that are stuck. Hallelujah. Praise the living God. We need $30,000. Praise our God.
Amen.
Hallelujah. To get our buses. We want to go city to city. Preaching the gospel of Jesus Christ. Praise the living God.
Amen.
Like never before. Hallelujah.
Glory.
So God is going to use you. If God touches you and you want to help us, praise the living God. Actually, to help yourself, sow a seed. Praise the living God. And let us get our buses out to go out and minister. And meet those people who have never heard of the gospel to the glory of God. And now God will bless you in Jesus' name. This Sunday, hallelujah, don't miss. Tomorrow, don't miss. Friday, don't miss. Our mother is going to be around. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Bring the sick. Bring the oppressed. Come on, favors way. Hallelujah. She's going to pray for everyone to the glory of God. And I believe you'll get your miracle in Jesus' gracious name. Hallelujah.
Glory.
Don't come alone. Come with somebody in Jesus' gracious name. On Sunday, hallelujah, we are going to hear so many testimonies to the glory of God in Jesus' gracious name. May God richly bless you and have a wonderful night in Jesus' gracious name. Thank you for being here. Thank you for being on this line. Today it has been special. Hallelujah. Because that's how God led our mother to do this in the name of Jesus Christ. And we thank God that it is done. And we know miracles are going to happen in Jesus' gracious name. Hallelujah.
Glory.
It is your season to be blessed, to be favored in Jesus' gracious name. May God richly bless you and have a wonderful night. Amen.
Amen.
Amen.